Now let us continue with forecasting. As we seen in our last video, you can see here after we decompose the time series method, we have so many types of variations, out of which we have completed random variation in our last video. So now today we'll see trend variation. So to solve trend variation, there are two types of method used. The first one is trend naive method. The formula to solve trend naive method is f of t is equal to a of t minus 1 plus a of t minus 1 minus a of t minus 2. Means f of t means forecast a certain period of time, and a means your actual demand at certain period. Or you can take another example. If you want to find forecast of March, then a of t minus 1 will be actual of February, a of t minus 1 will be actual of February, a of t minus 1, t minus 2 will be actual of January. So you require at least 2 months before to find trend naive period. And the second method which is used to solve is trend projection, which is also called as linear regression. In this, as you know, in the trend there is a linear progression in the demand. Means there is some trend, a linear trend. Either it might be going up or it might be coming down, so it will be a linear regression. So here the trend is going up. So in this method we require to find the slope of the line, which is B and A. So formula over here is y of t is equal to a of b t. So y of t here is your demand. Y of t here is your demand, means t y at a respected time. Y of t is equal to a is your here this measurement plus b is your slope of the line, and t is your time period, at which time period you are finding the demand. So using trend projection you can find demand at any point of time. To solve this, to get this equation, we need two things, that is a and b. So formula to find b is n means number of weeks you are counting for, summation of t into y, t is your time and y is your demand, minus summation of t into summation of y, means summation of time into summation of demand, divided by n into summation of t square minus summation of t the whole square. See the difference. Here it is summation of t square minus here it is summation of t the whole square. So here a is equal to summation of y minus b times summation of t divided by n. This is formula to find n. Once you find these values, you substitute this value in this equation over here, a and b, and at whichever time you require, say you require at period 8, you just substitute the value 8 and this a and b, and you will get demand at that period. So now let us see the first problem, which is using naive method, which is for trend. So you are given following data. The data is, you are given data for 5 weeks, and the demand for that 5 weeks is given. What was demand for that 5 weeks? Now they were told, using naive method for trend, find forecast for period 6. You have to find forecast for period 6 using the naive method. So if we plot this on a graph, what we will get? So how many weeks are there? As you know, on the x-axis it is t. So if you write on the x-axis, how many weeks are there? 5 weeks. So this is your time t, starting with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then y-axis. On y-axis it is your demand. So 0, so demand is between the range of 150 and 170, 180. So we'll add 0, 25, 50, 75, 100, 125, 150, 175, and say here it is 200. So let us plot this graph. How will plot the graph? At, so at week 1 the demand is 150, so you will get point somewhere over here. So week 2, the demand is 157. 157, it will come somewhere over here. In week 3, the demand is 162. So your 162 will come somewhere over here. 14 or 166 is somewhere over here, and then the last fifth week the demand is 177. So you will get demand somewhere over here. If you join these points, you can see a linear trend, means the trend is increasing. So since here the trend is increasing, so this is your demand. So since your trend is increasing, you can see it is a straight, showing a straight line, means the trend is increasing, and this is a trend type of problem. If I tell you to find, given the data, which type of variation it is either random, seasonal, trend, so you should be able to identify which type of variation it is. So here you can see this is a trend. So now the formula to find, so trend naive method. The formula is f of t is equal to a of t minus 1 plus a of t minus 1 a of t minus 2. So we want to find f of 6. So f of 6 means a of 6 minus 1 plus a of 6 minus 1 minus a of 6 minus 2. That means what? That is equal to a of 5 plus a of 5 plus a of 4. Actual demand of 5, actual demand of 5, and actual demand of 5. So actual demand of 5 is 177. So 177 plus, this is minus, plus 177 minus a of 4 is 166. If we calculate this data, you get 177 plus 177 minus 166, you will get as 188. So your forecast for period 6 will be is equal to 188. So this is the forecast using trend naive method. So this is first type of solution. So second type is using trend projection using linear regression. So here I copied the same table over here. There are 5 weeks, the same data, and first I have plotted a graph over here so that time is saved, and for your comfort I have written the formulas. So here the formula is y is equal to a plus bt. We have to find this. So for your convenience I have written this formula to find b and formula to find a. So now pay attention, what is required over here. So here you can see you require, I'm just writing this separately, I'm just splitting it out. You require summation of ty, you require summation of t, you require summation of y, here you require summation of t square, here you require whole summation of t, the whole square, means you require summation of t somewhere, and then you have to square it, and here same summation of t is required. So you require all these things to fit into this formula so that you will get the value for b and value for a. So for our comfort, for our easy doing, we'll draw a table and we'll find all this data. So you can see t. So I have written also t square, this is t square, then y, then ty, which is required. So I copy this data of t and y in this table. So as we know, I'll copy the data directly. So weeks are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 weeks, and the sales which are there, they are 150, 157, 162, 166, 177. So now, as I told you, we require all this t square, we require ty. So that will directly calculate in this table, so that it is easier for us to calculate further. So t square we have to do. So t square, 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, and 5 square is 25. Now what will be t into y? T into y means this t into y will get ty. So what is t in the first case? It is 1. Into y is 150. So it is 150. So second is the t is 2 and the sales is 157. So 2 into 157 will get 314. Then it is 3 into 162 will get 486. Then it is 4 into 166. You will get 664. Then you have 5 into 177. You'll get 885. So now here we know we have to find summation of ty, summation of t, summation of y, summation of t square, summation of t the whole square. So we require all these summations. So what we'll do, we'll take the summation of this t. How we'll take summation of this t? Summation of t will be is equal to, we have to add this all up. So it will be 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. You'll get summation of t as 15. Then what will be summation of t square? For summation of t square, you have to add all this up. So it will be 1 plus 4 plus 9 plus 16 plus 25. So you'll get summation of t square as 55. Then summation of y. What you'll get summation of y? Summation of y will be 150 plus 157 plus 162 plus 166 plus 177, you'll get 812. And then summation of ty over here. What is the summation of ty? 150 plus 314 plus 486 plus 664 plus 885. So it will be 2499. So you will get this data over here. Now remember one thing, I have written these weeks in numbers 1 2 3 4 5. If you are given in months January, February, March, April, May, you have to convert this into numericals. January will be 1, February will be 2, March will be 3, April will be 4, May will be 5. So you have to convert this before solving this problem. Now we'll go to our formulas. We have formula for finding B. So we should get, ultimately we want this equation A plus BT. So first formula is to find B. B formula is N into summation of T into Y minus summation of T summation of Y divided by n into summation of t square minus summation of t the whole square. So when we substitute data, now n will be how many data we have taken? 5 weeks of data. So n will be 5. Summation of ty is what now? Summation of ty, we have already found summation of ty is 2499. So summation of ty will be 2499 minus summation of t will be what? Summation of t will be 15 into summation of y will be what? Summation of y will be 812 divided by n is 5. Summation of t square is what now? 55 minus summation of t the whole square. Now we want to find summation of t the whole square. So it will be, so summation of t square 15 square. So 5 into 2499 will be 12495. 5 into 2499 will be 12495 minus 15 into 812. 15 into 812 will be 12180 divided by 5 into 55 will be your 275 minus 15 square will be 225. So if you solve this, 12495 minus 12180, you'll get 315, and 275 minus 225, you'll get 50. So if you divide this, 315 divided by 50, you'll get 6.33. So you got value of B. So now we'll find value of A. To find value of A, the formula is summation of y minus b summation of t divided by n. So your formula will be summation of y minus b summation of t divided by n. What is summation of y over here? 812. Minus, what is value of b we got? 6.3. And what is summation of t? Summation of t is 15. Divided by what is n? N is 5. If we calculate this, you'll get 812 minus 6.3 into 15. That is 94.5 divided by 5. So what answer you'll get? 812 minus 94.5. You'll get 717.5 divided by 5. So A will be equal to 717.5 divided by 5. You'll get 143.5. So you got value of A, you got value of B. Now we have our equation over here. We have our equation. What is our equation? Y is equal to A plus B T. So Y, we don't know. Value of A is 143.5. Value of B is 6.3 into T. So now you got this equation. Now how will you find forecast if you require? So now if someone tells you to find the forecast, now here it is given. How many periods? 5 periods are given. If someone tells you to find forecast of 10th period, so this is 5 period, someone tells you to find forecast of 10th week, what you'll do? So Y of 10th week, what will you forecast for 10th week will be? It will be 143.5 plus 6.3. We are finding for 10th week, so it will be into 10. So 143.5 plus 6.3 into 10 will be 63. So the answer will be 143.5 plus 63. You will get 206.5. This is approximately 207. Similarly, so if someone tells you to find 11th week, what you'll do? You'll try Y of 11th week will be 143.5 plus 6.3 into time is your 11. So that will be equal to 143.5 plus 6.3 into 11 is 69.3. So Y of your 11th week will be 143.5 plus 69.3. So that will be 212.8, which is approximately 213. So your forecast for 11th week will be 213. So this trend projection is advantageous because you can find projection for whichever week you want in future or whichever period you want in future. For example, here now we are given only for 5 weeks, but we can find for 10th week, we can find for 11th week projections. So here we finish with the trend projection, and in our next video we'll see the seasonal projection. Thank you.